Hey everybody, Bishop Randy Morgan here, and I'm coming to you today from my office at New Covenant Church of Atlanta, where the Spirit of God is being poured out upon all people. Today I want to talk to you for just a few minutes about the anointing, but before we do, let's pray. Father, thank you for everyone listening and everyone watching. I pray, God, that you teach us something about a dimension of something that we need more than anything else in this life. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. When you are born again, the Holy Spirit comes to dwell in you. There is a second experience with this precious person called the Holy Spirit. And it's a second dimension. It's a dimension where he overflows out of you. Whenever Jesus, he described it like this. He said, when the Holy Spirit comes to dwell in you, he becomes like a spring inside of you, welling up unto eternal life. And then he said two chapters later that the Spirit of God will become like rivers of living water that flow out of your belly. These two dimensions, the well dimension and the river dimension, are two distinct experiences with one Spirit. And the anointing is the baptism in the Holy Spirit, which is the second experience. The thing that I believe is lacking most in believers' lives today is the anointing of the Holy Ghost. We try to do everything out from under the outpouring of the Holy Spirit. We like to do church without the anointing. We like to sing without the anointing. I've heard preachers preach. I've heard teachers teach. I've seen multitudes of things without making sure that the Father was pouring out the oil of the Holy Ghost on what we were doing. The greatest need in every believer's life is the presence and an awareness of the presence of the Holy Spirit being poured out upon our lives. Now, I realize that when we're saved, the Holy Spirit comes to dwell in us, and he comes and just moves in, and he's always with us. But the second dimension, being filled to overflowing with the Holy Ghost, is something different. And we're not always filled. The Bible actually says in Ephesians, be being filled with the Holy Spirit. Constantly be being filled. So while we're born again once, we're filled regularly with the Holy Spirit. And so the anointing is that constant infilling that we pursue every day, that we chase after every day, that comes upon us in our prayer time, comes upon us in church, that comes upon us when we're alone with God. There's only one way to get more anointing in our lives, and that is spending concentrated time alone with God in the prayer closet. The anointing, Isaiah 10:27 says, removes burdens and destroys yokes. We should be constantly removing burdens and destroying yokes from atmospheres. If we go into Walmart, there should be something that emanates off of us. The anointing of the Holy Ghost, the presence of the precious Holy Spirit in our lives should be ransacking the kingdom of darkness in Walmart. It should be ransacking the kingdom of darkness at the oil change place. It should be constantly the anointing of the Holy Ghost. Now, I'm not talking about we should be walking around laying hands on people and then falling out behind cash registers. I'm not talking about that. I am saying the gentle, overwhelming power of the Holy Spirit should be present. People should be becoming different with encounters with us. And the anointing of the Holy Ghost will bring this about. Isaiah 10:27 again says, the anointing removes burdens and destroys yokes. People should be seeking after us individually. If you are somebody that you are a believer in Jesus, but you are seeking after help more than people coming to you to seek after help. And I'm not, you know, sometimes I've said that and people are like, yeah, people are calling me all the time. May not be true. You may just think that in your head. Speaking truthfully today. Look into it. Evaluate your life. Keep a journal. Go back after 14 days and look to see how many times you've talked about your problems versus how many times people have talked to you about theirs, and that you actually, through prayer, remove those burdens and destroy those yokes. Not made it better. Not put a Band-Aid on it, not told people, well, not put a Band-Aid on it. I'm talking about help remove the burden and destroy the yoke. That is the anointing. Luke 4:18 through 19, Jesus said, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, for he has anointed me to preach, to proclaim the acceptable year of the Lord, to give sight to the blind, to set the captives free, to mend the brokenhearted." These are all things that the anointing does and did in Jesus' life. Acts 10:38. Acts 10:38, it says that Jesus was anointed, and everywhere he went, he was doing good. He was casting out devils, healing the sick. Miracles were following him. I want to say today the anointing, and I'm going to probably do a video series on this, but we have to seek after. So I'm going to stop right now. We have to seek after a daily application of the anointing. In a couple of videos, I'm going to talk a little bit more about this, but when a priest, a high priest, was ordained, a priest, or a leper was cleansed in the Old Testament, they did two things. They took the blood of a sacrifice, sprinkled it on the person, then they took the oil, the anointing oil, and sprinkled it, or smeared it, both the blood and the oil. The blood formed a layer, and the oil came on after because the consecration had taken place. The blood of Jesus has been applied to us. That's when the Holy Spirit comes and dwells in us. But we need the sprinkling of the oil upon us, not just within us, but upon us, so that we can be equipped for ministry, that we can move forward in the things of God and live supernaturally. The anointing is the breaker that gets us into the supernatural dimension, the gifts of the Spirit, the healing of the sick, the giving of sight to the blind. And I'm talking about more than just physical eyes. I'm talking about spiritual eyes. I'm talking about the removal of burdens and the destruction of yokes. We must have the anointing. Here's how I encourage you to do it. Every day, Father, in Jesus' name, I ask you to anoint me with fresh oil. And I'll talk about that in a couple of videos too, about the anointing of fresh oil. It's actually in Psalms. David said, "I will be anointed with fresh oil." He was anointed, oil poured on his head three distinct times in his life and ministry, because he had to be equipped for new levels of responsibility. There's a fresh anointing for you today, a fresh anointing for you today if you'll receive it. But you got to ask for it. God doesn't just willy-nilly pour out. It has to be pursued. You have to be consecrated, and you have to pursue this costly anointing. All right, God bless you. Father, right now, I just pray in the name of Jesus that you bless everyone that's watched this and listened to this teaching. I pray, Father God, that you give them revelation knowledge about the anointing of the Holy Ghost. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, God bless you. I'll see you soon.